Good morning. I just want to have a small Bible study this morning with those that want to join me. I'm in Genesis, the 50th chapter, and I'm going to start with maybe the 18th verse. I'm in Genesis, the 50th chapter. What I want to talk about this morning is talk about life. I want to talk about pain. I want to talk about getting through life. I want to talk about how that God wants us to have an abundant life, but with the twists and the turns in life, sometimes it throws us because we think, we hope that life just goes along wonderful. There's no pain, there's no suffering, and especially there's no betrayal. We especially want to talk in these few moments about being betrayed, loving somebody, giving them your all, trusting them, being good to them, and then they turn around and stab you in your back. And many times it's just very hard to come to the truth, to understand that you love them, but they didn't love you. But the good news about that is that in Romans 8:28, the Bible says that we know that all things work together for good. So even the betrayal that we go through, and beloved, I don't think this has been talked about enough, because you're saved does not mean you don't have issues. And if you're still walking around with unresolved issues, with abandonment, with heartbreak, if you don't deal with your issues will deal with you. And so if you don't, like I said, deal with them, you'll never have that successful ministry. You'll never have that successful marriage. You'll never be have successful friendships. So let's look at Genesis, the 50th chapter, verse 18. The Bible says, "And his brethren also went and fell down before his face. And they said, Behold, we be thy servants. And Joseph said unto them, Fear not, for am I in the place of God?" We're here with Joseph. Y'all know the story of Joseph, how that Joseph was chosen. Joseph was blessed. His father gave him a coat of many colors. And because of that, his brothers, not outside people. You see, it's the folks that are very close in our life that mess us up. And if we don't know what's going on, if we cannot trust and have faith in God that God is taking care of these things, it will make us ineffective and will abort the ministry that God has put within us. You see, beloved, we are not here for ourselves. Each and every one of us is here for someone else. But we have to stay sane. We have to stay on the right balance. And that's the reason that good Bible teaching will let us know. Beloved, what has happened to us had to happen. It had to happen because, you see, without the betrayal, we cannot get where God is taking us. Do you remember in Matthew 16 when Jesus told his disciples, he told them, "I must needs go to Jerusalem, and the Son of Man will be spit upon, and the Son of Man will be put upon a cross, and he will be crucified, but on the third day he will resurrect." His disciples did not want him to go. Peter said, "God forbid that this should happen." But Jesus, because you see, God can see around corners. We can't. And many times we get all messed up because of what we're going through. And that's the reason that we have to know the word of God. We have to have faith. We have to believe. And the word of God tells us that this suffering that we're going through, this betrayal, this heartbreak that we're going through, that God is going to work it together for our good. Now, if God makes this statement in Romans, the 8th chapter, that would presuppose that these things that are happening are not good things. Everything that happened to you, beloved, I don't care how saved you are. I don't care how you read your Bible. I don't care how you pray. I don't care how you plead with God. Everything that happens is not good. But we know that everything is working together for our good. Beloved, pain has a purpose. And without pain, you do not know where you're going or what to do. It's a bad thing to be asymptomatic, because all of a sudden you're about to die, but you didn't have any symptoms. You didn't have any pain. We do not like pain. Something wrong with you if you like pain. But the pain pushes us in the direction that we're supposed to go. Glory to God. There is no way that a man would have a dynamic ministry and be able to minister to hurting people and be able to go forward in God without him himself being buffeted and him himself be having to suffer. Because you see, when God comforts us, then we can comfort others. And so then Joseph, because his brethren, the Bible says, because of how blessed he was. Let me tell you something, beloved. Some of what you're going through is because you're so blessed. You shine too much. It looked like that you're doing too well. And that causes people, if they're not spiritual people, it causes them to hate you and to devise. And then they want, have you ever noticed some people that when they hear that something has happened to you that's bad, look like they get joy out of it, look like you've been living too good, look like things are just too well for you? And so it was with Joseph. Joseph's own brothers, beloved, his own brothers. And the psalmist says, David says, speaking prophetically of Jesus and his suffering, the psalmist says that if it had been my enemy, I could have stood it. But it was my brother, my familiar, that lifted up his heel against me. Beloved, Jesus could not get to the cross without Judas. He needed someone to betray him in order for him to reach his destiny. I'm happy this morning because I'm going to tell you something. Sometimes all the way through life, you messed up because you ask yourself questions. Why did they do that? Why did they treat me like that? Why I was good to them. I loved them. Why did they do it? Baby, it's all working together for your good. God is taking it. God is yet in control. And that's the reason that you have to pray. And that's the reason that you have to allow the Spirit to move in your heart. Because if you walk by sight, you'll become discouraged and you'll quit and you'll give up. But we have to press, keeping our eyes toward the prize, knowing that God is in control. Look what the Bible says, and I'm going to lead us along. He says, am I in the place of God? See, Joseph's brothers had threw him all down in a pit. Can you imagine how a 17-year-old felt that they took him and threw him in a pit? He wouldn't even, if somebody came along and asked him, said, how did you get in here? He'd be ashamed to tell them that my brothers, not my enemies, oh, I'm getting some help this morning. Not my enemies, but my brothers, the one that's opposed. Brother, let me tell you something. I bring it on home. Ain't nothing like church hurt. When I first got saved, I was out in the streets. I was on dope and drinking and all that. When I got into church, I thought everybody in the church was right. And then when people started lying and then folks were doing things and you hear them talking about you behind your back, then you become disillusioned. But it had to happen. I had to be betrayed. I had to feel the pain, because the pain motivated me and moved me away from man and moved me to God. You see, the Bible says that we're supposed to look to Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. I'm not supposed to look to man anyway. And so then I've got to be wounded. And then I've got to be wounded in the house of God. I've got to be wounded among my brethren. I've got to be wounded by them that are close to my heart in order for me to understand that it ain't a dime worth of difference between people. And you cannot put your faith and trust in man, but put your faith in God. David said, I'm going to look to the hill from whence come happy now. I'm going to look to the hill from whence cometh my help. And so then they took him and put him in a pit. He went from the pit to Potiphar's house. And in Potiphar's house, he ended up in prison. He helped folks that would not help him when time came. But then one day, just one day, God removed him from prison and made him second in command. And that's where we get the name of our church, Manasseh, because Pharaoh gave him his daughter. And his daughter, and they had two children. One was named Manasseh, and the other one was named Ephraim. Now, Manasseh means that God have made me forget my hurt. You see, oh my God, the pain that it takes. I'm going to tell you something. God has given me a powerful ministry, but it was pain that brought me here. I could not sashay. I could not study. I could not give programs. I could not get a title to have the ministry that I have. The pain that I went through, the heartbreak that I went to, push me to this ministry where I have no other. I'm focused, and I'm focused on fulfilling God's purpose in my life. I'm not focused on making no money. I'm not focused on getting no titles. I'm not focused on becoming this or that in the church. The pain that I receive, the pain is real, y'all. The pain of life is real. It ain't no joke. It feels like some things can happen that seem like it's going to rip your poor little heart out. But it's not going to, you know what? A broken heart will not kill you. It'll just make you feel like you're going to die. But what it does is it strengthens you. It pushes you through to your purpose. And so Joseph, he names the children Manasseh and Ephraim. Manasseh means that God have made me to forget my pain. I want you to know something, that God, when he makes you to understand what your purpose is and where you're going, you're not mad at the folks that was used by Satan in order to push you where you were going. Because if it had not been for the pain, you'd have been lollygagging. Look, I don't like going to the doctor, but I want you to know something. That if I mess around and see some blood, or if it's enough pain or whatever, my wife ain't got to ask me to go to the doctor and everything. I'm gone. I went to the doctor today. Look, we won't move until, thank you, Jesus, until it's enough pain, I'm not going to move. But God uses the pain, the heartbreak, in order to move us from our self-interest and to move us from our foolishness into his purpose. And so Joseph named his first son Manasseh because he said, God have made me to forget my pain. And then in Ephraim means, and even the people that did it to him. Beloved, sometimes the folks that have misused us, they look at us and they think we have something against them. But you know what? We can look at them and say, baby, if it hadn't have been for you betraying me, if it hadn't been for you making a fool out of me, if it hadn't have been for you taking advantage of me, I'd never be where I am in God. I want you to know there's a peace that comes when you ain't trusting in no flesh. There's a peace that comes when you know that God got you. There's a peace that comes that you know that no matter what kind of ditch that you fall in, God has you. And so then Joseph here says in verse 20, he says, in verse 19, am I in the place of God? God did this. You didn't do it. But look what he says in verse 20. He says, but as for you, you thought evil against me. Beloved, let me tell you something. I was very naive. I felt like that if I loved you, you would love me. I felt like that if I treated you right, you would treat me right. I was very naive. I didn't understand. You know, I came here, a little red boy down in Elaine, Arkansas, loving everybody, wanting everybody. I always been the kind of person that I wanted. If I had it, I wanted you to have it too. But, you know, I remember an event changed my life. Maybe I was 8 or 9, a guy that I really liked. We were friends and everything. We were just kids there on the school campus. And in order to show out in front of some other children, he punched me in my stomach, embarrassed me, shame. You remember the first time you felt shame, felt embarrassment, felt shame? You know what I did? I reached over and got a mask and I put a mask on. And I learned that when I was embarrassed to take a mask on and act like it didn't matter to me. And I learned to get a first punch. And I learned to act like I was a gangster. I learned to act like I thought I was Superfly or Cher. But I want you to know that when you come into an understanding of God, you can take the mask off. You can think whatever you want to think about me. Because you know what? And a dime worth of difference between none of us. And if the Lord don't help us, we can't stand the storm. And so Joseph tells him, am I in the place of God? God did this right here. He said, but as for you, you thought evil against me. But God meant it under good to bring it to pass as it is this day to save much people alive. Beloved, because of the pain that you've gone through, God is preparing you to help other people. You see, if I had never gone down into the crack house, if I had never got kicked out of 3 universities, if I had never stole from my own mama, I wouldn't understand people like I understand them. You see, beloved, God had to allow me to do things that I thought I never would do. God had to allow me to go to a depth in life that I thought I never would. Beloved, my great-grandfather finished college in 1908 from Clark University. I was raised up. My granddaddy was the principal. Grandmother was a home ec teacher. My mom and dad. Well, I was never supposed to by man. So I graduated 15 years old, graduating from high school. I was the wonder child, always high IQ or whatever. But look at what happened to me. Look at kicked out of 3 universities, 53 hours of F's. I thank God for it. It had to happen. Oh, my God. It had to happen. And so then Paul says in 2 Corinthians 12th chapter, he talks about how he had a thorn in the flesh, and whatever it is that is holding you back, and he says, I ask God to remove it. But God said, I'm not going to remove this thing. I'm going to leave this pain here. I'm going to get off of here. I'm going to leave this pain here because this pain is what's going to bring you to me. This pain is what's going to bring you down to the bleeding side of Calvary. This pain is what's going to make you stop trusting in yourself. This pain is what's going to make you lean and depend upon me. And so then he says, and I'm closing the Bible. He says in 2 Corinthians, the 12th chapter, he says, I'm going to give you some good news, Paul. My grace is sufficient. If you just quit trusting in yourself and you trust in me, it had to happen. David says in the psalm, he said, it was good for me that I was afflicted. Beloved, I embrace everything that I've been through. Because Paul says, I'm persuaded that these present sufferings are not worthy to be compared with the glory which shall be revealed. If we suffer with him, we'll reign with him. I thank you, Lord, that they broke my heart. I thank you they never saw nothing in me. I thank you that they ran my name up and down. I thank you, God, by my mess up in my, and how that my name is all messed up. I thank you, God, because I ain't got nowhere to do but look up. I don't have nobody else to go to. And so then Joseph tell him, you meant it for evil, but God meant it for good. Let me tell you something, beloved. You got to be betrayed in order to get to your destiny. Ask Jesus. He had to get to the cross through Judas. Ask Samson. He never would have destroyed the temple except Delilah had turned against him. I thank God this morning. Oh my God. I thank God for the word of God. I thank God for the assurance of God. I thank God that he got us. And the things look bad and look like we can't make it and look like this is going ahead. But it's all working together for our good. I'm going to go to work. You have a blessed day. I love you.